अस्सलाम वालेकुम, हाउ आर यू स्टूडेंट्स? आई थिंक यू ऑल ऑफ यू विल बी फाइन. टुडे इन फिजिक्स इट इज़ आवर लेक्चर नंबर 5, मेजरिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स. मेजरिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स, टुडे इन मेजरिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी एंड डिस्कस स्क्रू गेज. Screw gauge is also a device which is used to measure the very smaller lengths up to 0.01 millimeters. Here is the diagram of a screw gauge, which will be explained to you later. Screw gauge. The screw gauge is an instrument used for measuring the diameter of a thin wire or the thickness of a sheet of metal. Very thin wires are being measured with the screw gauge, and very small thickness sheets could be measured with the screw gauge. Least count of screw gauge. Again, I am repeating that least count is that minimum value which can be measured with any particular physical instrument or measuring instrument. So here we will discuss the least count of screw gauge. A screw gauge is also known as a micrometer, is a precision instrument. Least count is equal to pitch over numbers of divisions of thimble, which is 5 over 50 and is equal to 0.01 millimeter. It means a screw gauge can measure as minimum as 0.01 millimeter. One division of thimble is equal to 0.01 millimeter with reference to the straight line on sleeve. This is the least count of screw gauge or micrometer. So one thing should be clear from this slide to you all students, that the minimum value which could be measured with a screw gauge is 0.01 millimeter, and this is the least count of a screw gauge. Now we are going to discuss the structure of a screw gauge. A screw gauge consists of a U-shaped metallic structure which is attached to a hollow cylindrical tube on one end. The hollow tube has a uniformly threaded nut inside it. A long stud with a plain face is fitted into this nut. Exactly on the opposite side of this nut and on the other end of the U-shaped frame, a smaller stud with a plain face is also attached. Faces of both the studs are exactly parallel to each other. Now again, on this diagram, U-shaped surface. There are two studs. One is this one and one is this one. The smaller stud is anvil and the longer stud is spindle. What happens? These both are parallel to each other. We have studied that these both are parallel to each other. This is the main scale of the screw gauge, which is called sleeve. And this is circular scale. This is the circular scale and this is the main scale. This is called sleeve and this is the circular scale. This is the main frame of the screw gauge. This is the thimble and ratchet. This is the ratchet. With the help of thimble, you can adjust the spindle and anvil, and you can place an object between these two studs which fixes it. The smaller stud is known as anvil and the longer one is known as spindle. The anvil is the fixed part of the device whereas the spindle moves as and when the head is moved. The frame carries both the anvil and the barrel and is also heavier than the rest of the bars. The object to be measured is held between the anvil and the spindle. Now look here. The object which is used to measure is to be measured is placed over here in between anvil and spindle. This is the frame. This is the heavy, you have studied that this is the heavier part of the screw gauge. This is the main scale and it is the circular scale. Working example. Now we will discuss its working example. Suppose you have fixed the spindle and anvil, you have tightened the screw gauge and placed an object in its frame in between anvil and spindle. Now this is the reading which comes to us. This is the reading. Look here in this diagram. This is the reading which comes to us. In the next slide, I have explained this reading. So first we move to the next slide. Suppose the scales came to the positions shown in the figure. The main scale reading would be the marking that is fully visible immediately to the left of the thimble. Main scale reading, left, this is the thimble, left of the thimble is, it is obvious. The main scale reading would be the marking that is fully visible immediately to the left of the thimble, that is 5.5 millimeter. Look here. It is 5.5. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And before 6, this is somewhere, this circular scale is somewhere between 5 and 6. It is crossing, nearly crossing 5.5. Now, for the auxiliary reading, the 30th division of the thimble matches with the main scale and thus its reading will be 0.30 millimeter. 0.30 millimeter. So, the final reading will be the addition of the readings of both the scale 5.5 plus 0.30 millimeter, which will be equal to 5.80 millimeter. Now again look at this picture. 5 and some more than 5.5. 5 and 0.5. It is crossing 5 and 0.5. Right. Now the 30th reading is somehow exactly near this main scale line. 30th reading is in front of the main scale reading. The readings on this scale are in 0.1 millimeter, 0.2 millimeter and so on. So 5.5 millimeter of this and plus 0.30 millimeter of circular scale will be added to each other and it will give us 5.5 plus 0.30 millimeter. This is the main scale reading which was shown on the sleeve and this is the circular scale reading. Both readings are added in each other to give a cumulative reading of that particular object which was placed in the frame of the screw gauge. So the final reading was 5.80 millimeter. Now this is the method to take readings on the screw gauge. Homework. Your homework is to measure the thickness of 1 rupee, 2 rupee and 3 rupee coin with screw gauge and you're going to write these values on your notebook as well, that what was the reading of these coins which you have taken with the screw gauge. Write this topic on your notebooks. You are also going to write this topic on your notebooks. Now, again, we are discussing some important points. Screw gauge is an instrument used for measuring the diameter of a thin wire or thickness of a sheet of metal. Its least count is 0.01 millimeter. Least count are the smallest reading which can be measured with a screw gauge. In its structure, we have studied that there is a frame and a sleeve. Frame, the object is fixed in the frame between anvil and spindle, and the readings is being taken on sleeve in this portion. This was the working example. You have calculated the value of object being placed in that picture. It was 5.80 millimeter, and then in the last it was your homework. Thank you so much.